Hola, bienvenidos a Sephania Services, Easy Way to Learn Español. Today we're going to learn how to describe physical appearance and character. ¿Estás listo? ¡Vamos! Describir a una persona físicamente. Describing a person physically. Ok, como puedes ver en la pantalla, tenemos unos ejemplos como alto, atlético, calvo, guapo. Ok, empecemos. In order to describe what a person looks like, you must use the verb ser, to be. Ok, también utilizamos el verbo tener. We also use the verb to have. We would go over that. Well, we use verb to have especially when describing like how a person eyes look like or hair, like does he or she has short hair, long hair, right? That's when we utilize the verb to have. But we're gonna see that on part two of this lesson, okay, in a future video lesson. Alrighty, so remember in the previous class we went over verb ser and estar, and when we went learning consonant ser, we saw that we use it when describing the physical characteristics, right? Or in this case, physical appearance, right? Let's go over quickly. If you remember the conjugation, soy, yo soy, tú eres, él, ella es, nosotros somos, vosotros sois, ellos son, right? Now, to find out from someone what they look like, we can ask the following question. ¿Cómo eres? ¿Cómo eres? And to reply, we use the relevant part of the verb, okay? Soy, I am, right? Soy alto, in this case. Soy alto. And you see that you have O and A, depending whether masculine and feminine, right? Well, if you haven't seen, if you haven't watched those videos, I recommend you check. I'll try to leave the link on the description below. But remember, the ending of an adjective changes depending on whether you are the person that you're describing is male or female, and on whether you are describing one or more than one person. Okay, I made already videos concerning definite articles, and I go over some rules and regulations, and you will see what sort of articles we use, and the ending on what ends on O, one ends on A, and so on and so forth. Okay, so I advise you to go over those if you haven't done it yet. All right, so use the following adjectives to describe someone physically. So we have the first example. If we go back, we have the first example here. Yo soy alto. Yo soy alto. If this was a woman, it would be yo soy alta. Okay. Now we have another example. Atlético. Atlético. Or in this case, because the lady, atlética. Tú eres atlética. Okay, this reminds me of one of my sisters. Her name is Soleya. Soleya, tú eres atlética. Now we have calvo. Calvo. Él es calvo. Él es calvo. Muy bien. Ella es rubia. Rubia. If it was a male, rubio. Okay? Rubio, rubia. Okay? Fantástico. Brunette. Okay, here's the situation. Now, moreno o morena. Okay, let's go with the example first. Él es moreno. Now, moreno o castaña. This is like brunette. Well, castaña is chestnut, but literally chestnut. It means chestnut. But what it is talking about is the color of your hair. Now, here in Spain, we describe or we say that somebody is moreno or morena, moreno or morena, according to the color of the hair. So as you see, this guy got brown hair. They will say he's moreno in here in Spain. They will say él es moreno, as you see here. Él es moreno. Now, where I come from, which is South America, Venezuela to be precise, when we say somebody es moreno o morena, we're talking about a dark-skinned person. So, for example, we see a dark-skinned person, we say he is moreno o él es moreno, ella es morena. This could be, I'm speaking from Venezuela, from the Venezuelan perspective, I'm sure it's the same in the Latin America or Hispanic, Spanish speaking countries. Morena, morena is according with describing somebody that is dark skin. But here in Spain, when they say moreno, morena, they're talking about someone that has brown hair. I know, right? There you have it. Just want to clarify it for you, in case you don't get confused. Now, guapo. Guapo o guapa? Guapo o guapa? In this case, we have a male, so diríamos, él es guapo. Él es guapo. If it was a female, ella es guapa. Okay? Now, this word, again, this is mostly used here in Spain. Okay, in Venezuela and other Spanish-speaking countries, they may say different words, como bonito, bonita, so on and so forth. Hermosa, but guapa is a word that I personally learned being or living here in Spain. Next, gordo o gorda. Gordo o gorda. Nosotros somos gordos. ¿Por qué nosotros? Because there's plural. There's three persons here. There's three people. So, nosotros somos gordos. Now, this can be... This is also used not as a derogatory term, but as... If the word comes to my mind. Like in a kind way, if I can say. Like, for example, my sister... she calls somebody, her husband, gordo. Not because he's fat, it's just I don't even really know how to explain it. But sometimes they use this word not as in an offensive way, if you know what I mean. Alright? So, gordo o gorda. You can, obviously, if somebody is overweight, you can describe the person like that. Oh, la chica gorda o el chico gordo, right? Without meaning anything negative about it. Okay, next, bonita. Bonita. This is mostly used when talking about ladies. Bonita. Vosotras sois bonitas. Sois bonitas. Vosotras sois bonitas. Guapo. Now, you had good looking and handsome. You see, kind of, well, same word is used to describe handsome and good looking. Guapo. O guapos, because of course this is more than one person here. So, ellos son guapos. Ellos son guapos. ¿Cómo son ellos? Ellos son guapos. Muy bien. Now, there's a few more adjectives here. For example, pelirrojo o pelirroja, rejere, also known as ginger. Pelirrojo o pelirroja. Now, I want you to write down in your notes or in the comments. You can leave your answer in the comment below, section below. For example, how will you formulate this sentence? Ella... Mm-hmm. Okay, you have to write it down and practice or say it out loud. Pelirroja, pelirroja. What will you use? What conjugation of the verb starts? Soy, somos, es, vosotros. Which one? Right. Tenemos bajo o baja. Por ejemplo, yo soy baja. I'm short. Yo soy baja. O bajita, but we'll go in detail in the future with that. Bajo o baja. Tenemos esbelta. Esbelta. pequeño o pequeña, okay, pequeño o pequeña, you can do the same, write a sentence using the adjective that you see here. For in this case is ella, in this case is él, ella, él. And then you need to complete the sentence. Vamos ahí. Pelirrojo o pelirroja, bajo o baja, esbelta, pequeño o pequeña y grande. Muy bien. Tenemos ugly, que sería feo o fea. As you see, I didn't put a picture because who are we, right? To, I don't know, to decide who's ugly and who's not, you know? Hallelujah. So, ugly, feo o fea, skinny, flaco o flaca, thin, delgado o delgada. For example, ella es delgada, right? Delgado o delgada. Y fuerte, fuerte. Ellos, need to complete that. Fuerte. Muy bien, excelente. ¿Qué te ha parecido la clase? ¿Te ha gustado? You enjoy? If you have any suggestions, please leave it in the comment section below. And stay tuned for future video lessons, okay? Now, here's a question for you. ¿Cómo eres tú físicamente? ¿Cómo eres tú físicamente? Okay? You can leave your answer in the comment section below. Okay? Excellent. And that's all for now. Eso es todo por ahora. Gracias. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for future video lessons. And have a good day. Bye for now. Hasta la próxima clase.